Terra Nullius was a land rights law whose terms were used in early Australia at the time of its settlement. Today we'll focus on Terra Nullius in Australia and on three main focus questions that we will answer. These are as follow. Why was Terra Nullius used as a law? How was Terra Nullius misused? Who fought against its misuse, and what impact did this law have on Aboriginal people? Question 1. Why was Terra Nullius used as a law? Firstly, Terra Nullius was used as a law so unoccupied land could be legally claimed by another country or sovereignty of the state, which is where this law has most of its flaws, but we will cover that later. Terra Nullius is also a term used to describe land that is unoccupied or has never belonged to anyone and thus never belonged to the state which claimed it. However, there were certain rules to claiming land around the time that Captain Cook claimed Australia for Britain. If the land was uninhabited, it could be claimed under Terra Nullius. If the land was already inhabited, you could arrange to buy the land from the owners, or you could claim it through invasion or forced removal. Basically, Terra Nullius was used as a law in order to protect people from having land that rightly belonged to them taken from them. Question 2. How was Terra Nullius misused and who fought against its misuse? So as I was saying, good old Captain Cook, upon returning to Britain after his first voyage to Australia, claimed that no one inhabited the Newfoundland of Australia and claimed it for Britain. Cook seemed to believe that the Aboriginal inhabitants of Australia were not sophisticated enough to be owners of the land at all, and therefore the land was Terra Nullius. Mr. Cook's call wasn't very popular with the native inhabitants of Australia at all. Anyway, sure enough, settlers began to move to Australia, much to the disdain of the natives who had fought for the land which, according to Britain's own land laws at the time, rightly belonged to the Aboriginals. The new settlers behaved appallingly to natives because they were not as technologically advanced as the white man. Eddie Mabo was a man who led the fight for Indigenous land rights and was a part of a landmark decision of the High Court which overturned the legal doctrine of Terra Nullius. Question 3. What impact did this law have on the Aborigines? One of the major impacts from Terra Nullius was the stolen generation. This was when children with Aboriginal mothers and European fathers, also known as half-castes, were taken away from the family and tribe. They were put in camps where they were told it was for the best that they were put there. The second major impact was the drop of the Aboriginal race. This was mainly due to heavy massacres and lack of food and water. The settlers committed many gruesome and inhumane acts towards the Aboriginals. Some of these acts included violation of Aboriginal women, decapitating their babies, and murdering the men. It's no wonder then that the Aborigines fought back. Vicious groups of Aboriginal warriors would attack settlers' farms, steal stock, and torch houses. However, these men with spears and arrows were no match for the white men and their muskets. So slowly, the natives were pushed further and further inland, away from their homelands. Aboriginals who stayed behind and had few ways of gathering food scrounged around farms at night stealing food. But soon, farmers noticed and Aboriginals became legal game for hunting. Yep, open season for the poor Aborigines. Terra Nullius was a horrible law, decreasing the Aborigine population and removing them from their sacred homes and tribes.